The title of this video is "Shall We Go Back to Communism?" Communism. Why did it collapse? Is it better than capitalism? If it is better than capitalism, why is it better than capitalism? Is it is this time right to come back to communism? Let's look at capitalism. Capitalism, we don't have to define it. We know it. We live in it. The whole world, most of the world, 99% of the world is capitalist nowadays. There is world trade. There is globalism. So that's capitalism. It's an amazing system. It's giving fruits and everything. But it's an amazing system for who? That's the question. It's an amazing system for about a couple billion people, or maybe 1.5 billion people. It's an amazing system. For the rest, it's not such a great system. And for the last 2 billion, the poorest 2 billion, it's a horrible system. So when you hear Americans talking about it, when you hear French or you hear English, British talking about capitalism, they talk because they talk from their point of view. And you can't blame them because that's what they see. And you need to live in a country or maybe be from a country that is from the last 2 billion to not like capitalism so much because it hasn't worked for you. So far, it hasn't worked for you. Communism. Let's look at communism. Communism is a system that was, that's an idea that was developed and brought by a guy called Karl Marx, and he brought this system. And this system basically says that capitalism is inherently unjust and it's going to collapse at some point. And there's people that tried communism. The Soviet Union tried it for 90 years, didn't work for them. Why didn't work? Why did it collapse? Who made the Soviet Union collapse? It's not the US. It's nobody. It's themselves. It's their system. This system was too, they couldn't, they had a problem with distribution. It comes down to that. Distribution was very difficult, and management of, state management of resources was done with pencil and paper. So they didn't have computers, they didn't have sophisticated systems, they didn't have artificial intelligence. If they did have these things, could communism have survived? Could it have flourished better than capitalism? My guess is yes. And do we have to go back to communism? Some form of communism is of socialism is necessary. And there is all social systems all around Europe. I mean, there's plenty of social. There is no pure capitalism. But can we go back to more capitalism? Say, for example, like basic income, something like that, where everybody gets an income from the state. Can we afford it? Yes, we can. Can we manage it? Yes, we can. Why do I say that? Because of AI, because of computers. Computers came out of age. They came to the point where they can help us manage this system of distribution. The system of state management can be done, but not state management in the sense of the Soviet Union, where the state... where you can't talk, where you cannot have a market of ideas, where you cannot have... It's a little bit... what I'm suggesting is a system that is a little bit more socialist than European systems now, a bit like the Swedish system, the Swedish model, or the Scandinavian model. Those systems will work better for the world, and those systems, if we can help... the last 2 billion, the poorest 2 billion people, adopt them as well. They will help them in their lives. Capitalism is amazing. Believe me, I live in capitalism. I benefit from capitalism so much. But this is just to start a discussion. Shall we go back to communism and why? Because of distribution problem has been solved because of AI. And it might work, and it might actually work. And people have been talking about basic income for such a long time. So that's it. Your comments, maybe. Do you think we should go back to communism? If we do go back to communism, I'm not talking about communism, I'm talking about socialism. So like following the Scandinavian system. Okay, thank you. Bye.